Like Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look in the 5 and 10.
With the fiscal cliff looming, the market's running wild, uncertainty in Europe. We're asking, where should you be putting your money? More specifically, it was a cover story of Bloomberg Businessweek's latest edition, Get Rich Slow. Joining us now from the Tel Aviv Stock Exchange, one of the financial planners that were actually featured in this article, Meir Statman. He's also the author of the book, What Investors Really Want, and has been named one of the most influential people in the advisor community. Mayor, we're just looking at the stock returns this year, 14%. That's how much S&P 500 stocks are up this year. Did most of investors, retail investors, miss this rally?
Oh, yes. And they're likely to miss it some more if they wait. And I'm not suggesting anything about the market timing. I'm simply suggesting that fear is preventing many investors from having some of their portfolio in stocks, and that's a very bad idea.
Well, are we, Meir, going to look at this as we did coming out of the 1930s depression as a generation-long attitude that people are going to be afraid to get back into the markets?
I don't think that it's going to take that long, but it is amazing how long it does take because, of course, as you know, the stock market has fully recovered, surely when dividends are taken into account. And so the question really is, why is it that people have not caught on? And the answer, I think, is in that fear. It is that we still feel as if it is 2008 and 2009, and even though the market is up, it is sure to go down, and God knows the politicians are doing their best to promote that.
Well, what happens, though, when people do everything right and they still can save? So I've heard stories about people saving for their kids' college tuition fund. It got to a good level, then 2008 hit, and now they can't pay for college. You do everything right, and you still don't get the money that you need. How do you recover from that?
Well, as you do in most other parts of life, you know, we get married and some of us get divorced. Some of us get the kids that we don't want. And I think that the stock market is just like that. The stock market is risky. It means that you can lose your money. And if people didn't believe it until now, they surely believe it now. But still, all we can do is make good decisions. And we hope for good outcomes, but they cannot be assured. And that is life. You cannot take risk out of life.
Well, with interest rates at rock bottom levels, hurting savers, pretty much set to stay that way for 2013, would you be advising your clients right now to get into the stock market to increase their exposure to stocks?
Well, first, I'm a professor, actually, not an advisor. But when I speak to my students, I say, put some of your money in equities. Have a diversified portfolio. That is my point. Not that I am making a forecast about where stock markets are going to go next year. It is simply the matter of having a diversified portfolio that includes a good portion of stocks, especially for young people, because surely just living on the interest rate is not going to be pleasant. And young people who put it all in bonds are going to find that they just don't have enough money to retire on.
Quickly, Meir, how much should I be saving?
How much? Say that again.
Meir, how much should I be saving?
How much? As much as you can. But you know, in Israel, where I am now, there is mandatory savings by employers and employees, and that comes to 20% of salary, and that is not including Social Security. And so 20% is a hefty portion for most people, but if you can, that's not a bad idea.
All right, great to check in with you, get some investing tips for 2013. Meir Statman, he's featured in the issue of Bloomberg Business Week. On stands now, Get Rich Slow. He's one of the advisors there in that article, the author of What Investors Really Want.